In this week's Purchase or Pass, we check out something truly unique that most people would never have considered before. It's a water tank. And this one was originally converted in the 1990s. The property has 4 beds, 3 baths, parking for 6 cars, and is located just 6 kilometres from the centre of the CBD. The house has very thick concrete walls, so no doubt you'll feel very protected. The living area is on 3 levels and features a hollow centre. The open balcony areas feature 360-degree views of the city. Now, John, on the show before, in this Purchase or Pass, we've done churches, prisons, stables, and now we've got a water tower. Is there anything that can't be converted into residential? Because that's the ultimate value, isn't it, generally, as residential?
Yes, it is, depending on the view and the position that you've got. If you had a water tower out in the middle of the country, I don't think you'd do too well, but if it's got good, solid views, it's probably going to do quite well.
I actually live in a round place as well, so we've got a whole floor apartment and it's completely round. And it is a completely different way of living compared to being in a square one. So if you like art, it's not the best place to live because there's no square walls. But you do get a fantastic view with these round buildings.
Yes. However, I don't think it's everybody's cup of tea.
Sure.
And the consequence of that is that when you go to sell it, you may not get as high a level of demand for it as you might like. And so it would be very easy to overcapitalise it. This is an emotional purchase if you're going to purchase it.
Because these are unique things, you're really after 5% of the market. So if you hit it the nail on the head, you could make a fortune and someone will pay a really expensive price, but it could be half price.
In a down market, it's not going to do terribly well. And so in a down market, it's a fantastic buy. In a really up market, however, where there's plenty of opportunity, it's probably going to do okay. So in other words, you buy these properties in a down market and you sell them in an up market. So it's the right time to be selling it now.
And at around $2 million, how important is it to get the right kind of architects and the right quality of fit outs?
Well, renovating something like this, I think, requires a very lateral mind and a very creative person. And so you're going to need a really good quality architect to actually get anywhere with this sort of building. Otherwise, you're going to end up with a water tower that looks like a water tower and feels like a water tower.
Yeah. So potentially more of a home than an investment, but purchase or pass for you?
For me, I always like to think I'm going to make money, so I would pass. I want capital growth and demand.
Now, I know I'm an ex-accountant and normally I've got no emotion, you can ask my wife that, but I absolutely love this property and think that the views would be absolutely fantastic and the perfect place for having a party there. I'm not sure if it would make the best investment, but compared to the sub-million-dollar properties, but there's always space in the portfolio for an emotional purchase, and this one would be one for me, especially with a 6-car garage, so I'm going to purchase on this one.